Okay, so let's talk about a property that you're going to purchase in based on the soil types. Now you can get your agent, your land specialist agent can produce a map through some various softwares that will give you a map showing all the soil types on your property. But to a layman that doesn't necessarily need to know Algoma loam versus silica sand, look at it from this level. You have light soils, you have heavy body soils, and then you have clay-based soils, and you have sandy soils. That's what I see most often. Nice, well-bodied, loamy soil is that black, rich soil that you see in Iowa, for example. It grows great soybeans, great corn. It's more expensive. It's going to cost you the most. In my area, where I'm here in western Wisconsin, northwest Wisconsin, we tend to have lighter soils, is what we say. And what we mean there is they're not as dark and heavy as a loamy soil, but they're not super sandy as well. They tend to be lighter with a higher sand content, not as good of organic material. They don't hold moisture really well. They may absorb the moisture, but the moisture either evaporates out or gets taken up by the plants. So it's much more susceptible to droughty conditions. If you don't get regular rains, that can be a problem. Other areas you might have super wet soils. So if you get in an area, let's say in Rusk County, Wisconsin, it tends to be very flat. The water table is very high, and it has very clay-based soils. When you have that soil, it's really hard to work. It usually stays wetter into the spring. It stays colder, so you can't get a plant to grow because it stays cold and wet. And then when it dries as hard as concrete. It like bakes hard, and you can't plant on it. So that's not so good. But if you're building, you also might find that it doesn't percolate well. So you hear perk tests, and for a conventional septic or a mound system or a tank, you have to have percolation. And clay soils won't perk. So now you're building a mound system for your septic, and that's going to cost you more. So when you're looking at a property to purchase, you got to kind of look ahead and say, well, how do I want to use it? If I'm a food plotter, light soils I can work with. Clay soils are going to be tough. If I'm an ag farmer, I want to plant row crops, then loamy soils is what I'd prefer. I could probably deal with lighter soils leaning towards sandy, but I'm probably going to have to cover crop it. Otherwise, I'm going to have droughty conditions. So it's just, how you're going to use it kind of dictates the soil and what it means to you.